गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 2 फॉर क्लास 8। वी आर डीलिंग विद द चैप्टर चैप्टर नंबर 9, फूड प्रोडक्शन। सो चिल्ड्रन, इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दैट व्हाट इज व्हाई द फूड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड हाउ द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दे आर एबल टू कल्टिवेट द फूड एंड नाउअडेज वी आर एबल टू ईट द कुक्ड फूड। Previously, when in the ancient time, the animals, they were, even the humans, they were eating the raw food. Simply, they were eating the animals, the plant product. They were not in the habit of cooking that food. But nowadays, we are in the habit of cooking food. So, in this chapter, we are going to study that how in different industries, how in different through the branch of biotechnology, through the branch of microbiology, how we are going to discuss, how we are going to make different type of plant product, and we can consume those plant product for a long time. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about some microorganisms and which type of microorganisms are present and what is the use of those microorganisms in our day-to-day life. And whether all the microorganisms, they are harmful for us, or some of the microorganisms, how they are useful for us too. So in the previous lecture, we had discussed about what are microorganisms. So as I have told you, microorganisms are the organisms that cannot be seen with the naked eye because they are very small in size. So for seeing them, we need a microscope. So such type of organisms are called microorganisms, and the science that deals with the study of microorganisms, that science is called microbiology. Other than that, I have told you that some are organisms are multicellular, some are unicellular. So I have given you the example of virus, bacteria, fungi, algae and protozoans. So some are multicellular, some are unicellular. So we had discussed about bacteria. So, in that I have told you the structure of bacteria. You have to draw that structure in your copy. Other than that, we had discussed about the uses of bacteria in food industries. So, in that we had discussed about curd and how we bake curd and which type of different type of bacteria are present in the curd. Then we had discussed about cheese, how we make the cheese. Okay. Then tea, day-to-day life we use the tea also, how we are using the bacteria to make tea, alcohol and vinegar. Vitamins, and after that we have discussed about agriculture. In agriculture, as I have told you, in some of the plants, their roots contain one bacteria. That bacteria is called Lysobium bacteria. This bacteria is present in the roots of leguminous plants like pea. So what is the function of that Rhizobium bacteria? This Rhizobium bacteria, it helps to fix the atmospheric nitrogen present in the atmosphere, and this nitrogen is used by plants. Okay, so when the nitrogen is using by the plants, so which type of bacteria are present? One is the Rhizobium bacteria, another bacteria are such like Nitrosomonas, Nitrobacter. These are the bacteria which are very helpful for the soil. They enrich the soil with nitrogen. So such type of bacteria, they are very useful for us. Now, today we are going to take the second microorganism, that is fungi. So fungi, as I told you, bacteria are the unicellular organisms, but fungi, they may be unicellular or may be multicellular. So first, if you don't have open your book, just take out your book and see. In page number 84, you can see a bread is there. On the bread, you can see some blackish spots are there. So these blackish spots, what are these? These are the fungi. If we bring bread from outside, after the use of bread, what we do? We simply keep the bread inside the refrigerator. We do that thing. So whenever we want to use, then we take out the bread from the refrigerator, and at almost there is an expiry date for bread also. So when we purchase the bread, we generally see the expiry date. So almost for 1 week, the bread is will be in a good condition. Otherwise, after the expiry date, we should not use such products, because at that time there will be a rise of fungi on those products. So you can see that the black spots, what is this? That is a fungi. Okay, and we call it a, because it is on the bread, so we call it bread mold. And which type of fungi is that? That is rhizopus. Okay, other than that, you can see in the second picture, that is a mushroom. So mushroom, you can see this is a cap shaped mushroom. Nowadays in rainy season, lots of mushrooms are available. So it is not green in color, it is reddish in color. Even the bread is also, it is blackish in color, it is not greenish in color. One more picture is given in your book, that is a white mushroom, and the name is given here, that is a poisonous mushroom. So you can see this blackish spots on the mushroom, it is not completely white, it is, the color has changed. So whenever we are purchasing the mushroom from outside, we should be very careful, and we should purchase the mushroom from a reliable shop, because proteins contain lot of mushrooms contain lot of proteins. It is highly nutritive. It contains lot of proteins and minerals. But if we are not eating good mushrooms, those mushrooms are very poisonous even. So you can see that these mushrooms, they are simply button shaped mushrooms, but they are also not greenish in color. They are the plants, but they are not greenish in color. Now so what we can say, that fungi, they do not have chlorophyll, thus they cannot prepare their food by their own. Why they will not be able to prepare their food by their own? Because they do not contain chlorophyll in them. So if they don't have the chlorophyll, they are not preparing their food by their own. So how they eat? What they eat? They live on the dead and decaying organic matter. Okay, dead and decaying organic matter. So that is why these bacteria, they are also called saprophytes. Saprophytes means rotten. Rotten means whatever the things, whatever the dead organisms are present inside the soil. Fungi, they feed on that decay and dead organic matter. So the organisms, what is the definition of saprophyte now? The organisms which are feeding on dead and decaying organic matters, those organisms are called saprophytes. Okay, now because they are eating the dead and decay organic matter, so they are also called natural cleaner of environment, because naturally, because they want their food, so in return what they are doing, they are just cleaning their environment in a natural way. They are cleaning the environment. So saprophytes, they are useful for us because they are eating the dead and decay organic matter present in the soil. So they are the natural environmental cleaner. So what type of question arises here? What are saprophytes? How fungi prepares the food? Why the saprophytes, they are also called natural cleaner of the environment? Okay, so all the answers are present within this paragraph. Now some of the common example of fungi, as I have told you also, I have shown you the picture of bread also. So bread mold. Bread mold is a type of fungus. What is the name of that? Bread mold, and the name of fungus is Rhizoporus. Second type of fungi, we can say it, mushroom. Okay, and one of the most important is the yeast. Yeast is a very, very useful unicellular fungi. So yeast, children, you all like to eat pastries, we all like eating cakes. Okay, so what we do, just when we are making the cake at home, sometimes some people use egg. If non-vegetarians are there, they can use the egg. But if suppose vegetarian are there, so they don't like to eat egg. At that time, what they do? They use a plant product that is called yeast. Because fungi is a plant. So they use yeast. Now, what is the habit of that yeast? Yeast, if we go to the market and we ask the shopkeeper, just give the yeast to us. So they have the small packets. In those packets, they just store the yeast. At that time, the yeast is in powdery form. Just if we buy, purchase a packet, small packets, very small packets, you can say these packets are in gram, milligrams. So small packets are available, and we just bring the packet at home, and those yeast, we just take a sugar syrup in a bowl, we just add water, and in the water we add sugar, and then we add a pinch of yeast in that we have purchased from the shopkeeper. So what is the habit of that yeast? Yeast, slowly and slowly it develops, but it doesn't take time when we provide it sugar solution or a water. Okay, so what is the property of yeast? Property, immediately the yeast, it changes into large amount. Slowly and slowly the yeast, it changes into large form. If suppose you have added a pinch of yeast, and within half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hour, your whole bowl will be full of that yeast. Okay, so same thing it happens when we use the yeast in making cakes. You can see in this, the cake, the size is small, but when we have added the yeast in this, after some time there will be a rise, and that rise is because of the yeast. So first we are going to discuss about the yeast. Okay, now what is the structure of yeast? The simple structure of yeast is, it contains a vacuole. We have already studied about vacuole. It is an empty space filled with sometimes the watery substance. The outer part of the yeast, it contains a cell wall. This yellowish part that you can see in the picture, that is the cytoplasm. It also contains a nucleus. Other than that, it contains some glycogen granules and some fat vacuole. These are the vacuoles and these are the glycogen granules. So as I have told you, yeast is a unicellular fungi. It mainly contains cell wall, nucleus and cytoplasm. Okay, it have different type of shapes. It according to the cell wall, maybe oval shape, maybe round shape, maybe irregular shape. Okay, what is the function of that yeast? It grows when it will be, it is given here also in your book. Yeast is found freely in the atmosphere. They are readily grow in all kind of sugary solution and in any plant containing sugar. Now, which type of plant contain sugar? For example, grapes, they are sweet in taste. Nectar of flowers, that is also sweet in taste. Sugar cane is also sweet in taste. So whenever they get such type of plants, they start their growth on that. So that is why we have seen that the farmers, they spray the fungicides, pesticides, fungicides, especially fungicides for removal of fungi. So mainly because grapes are sweet, sugarcane is sweet, nectar of flower is sweet. So whenever they are getting that sugary solution, immediately the growth in the yeast, it start. At that time, so the yeast, they increase in their number. So the yeast is, and that is only a structure of yeast. Now, what are the uses of yeast? Okay, as I have told you, the first use, that it is used for making breads. It is used in bakeries. So why it is used in the bakeries? Simply, it is used in the bakeries to soft the bread. When we make the bread, it becomes soft. And why we have given the expiry date on bread? Because the yeast, for some time, it is when it is given some temperature, and we have used our bread for some time, it will not be able to grow. But when the expiry date arises, at that time the amount of yeast present in that bread, it will start increasing, and at that time the bread we are getting, that the fungi is starting arising on that bread. So the softness in the bread and other baked fruit products, baked means whatever the baked thing that we use, just like patties, pastries, all due to the presence of air space in them. So these air space, they are formed because
because of yeast, the CO2 concentration increases in those dough, and that is also called fermentation of yeast. Fermentation of Maggie. Fermentation of yeast. So, the fermentation of yeast, just like in the Maggies also, if we keep boiled Maggies, after some time we keep them in the outer side, not in the fridge, and we are keeping them for 1, 2, 3 days. Even the chapatis also, we are keeping them outside for a long time. So some smell start arising. Okay, so bakeries, they use it for a short period of time, and after when the product is formed, they store them in a cool place. When we are storing them in a cool place, then they will not be increased. The yeast will not be increased. So that is why we keep the products in the cool place. Whatever the food items we make, especially the food items, we store them in a proper place. Otherwise, there will be a rise of yeast. Okay, next is yeast. They contain vitamins of B group, E group, or 15% proteins. So they are again important for us. In breweries, breweries means some people, they are in the habit of taking wine, whiskey, beer. So how the people in the industries, they make wine, whiskey, or beer, such type of products. So mainly that is produced by, when in the sugar solution, it converts into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide by the addition of yeast. It is already given in your book also. Yeast undergo fermentation in the presence of sugar solution. As I have told you, yeast undergo fermentation. Fermentation means it start increasing in the number in the sugar solution. When it is increasing in the number in the sugar solution, it produces ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. So at that time, it is also used in the breweries. First, it is used in the food, it is used in the breweries, it is used in baking, it is used in making bread, as well as it plays an important role in the manufacture of vitamins and proteins. Okay, so what you have to do, children, you have to just draw the diagram of yeast and write the importance of yeast. Okay, already given in that page, importance of yeast. Other than that, you have to write what are saprophyte, why they are called the natural cleaner of environment, and what is the food for the saprophyte, how they make their food. Okay, children, now the next topic, that is agriculture primary food source, we are going to take in the next lecture. Just read the chapter carefully and notes, as well as the question of the exercises I will give you on after the completion of the chapter. Thank you, children.